In this illustration, we'll calculate the moment of inertia of a triangular lamina. Here, we are required to find the moment of inertia of a thin uniform equilateral triangular plate of mass m, edge length l, about an axis passing through its centroid normal to its plane. Here, in solution, if we draw the figure, the situation is like this. We are given with a triangular equilateral lamina, and an axis of rotation is passing through its centroid. And about this axis, we are required to find its moment of inertia. Say we consider it as I, and the length of each edge is given to us as L, and its mass is M. And in this situation here, we can say the moment of inertia is always proportional to the square of any dimension of the given object. So here we can consider if mi of the given triangular plate is taken as I is equals to gamma ml square, where gamma is a constant, we are required to calculate the value of this constant. So, we get the value of this moment of inertia. Now, in this situation, to analyze it, one way is we consider an element and integrate the element. And another way is I can visualize if I consider an identical triangular plate at all three edges of this lamina. Then we can see a big triangular plate is framed, which is of length 2L, and its mass will be due to four plates. This will be 4M. So in this situation, for this big plate, we can say if we calculate moment of inertia of a big triangular plate formed by adding three identical plates as shown, then we can calculate this moment of inertia should be given by I for the big plate, should be given by the same expression, which is gamma times the mass will change to 4m and length will change to 2l whole square. And this becomes 16 times gamma ml square, or it should be 16i. Now, in this situation, if we calculate this I big by using parallel axis theorem, as three plates are added, and we consider this plate and an axis which is passing through its centroid, and moment of inertia about this axis will be I, and here, if we calculate the separation between these two distances, then here we can see distance between these two centroids, this distance, if C equals to D, then we can calculate the separation between centroids of two plates as shown is, this is written as D, and the value of D will be L by root 3. So, we can write that moment of inertia of big plate is equals to moment of inertia of central plate plus thrice the moment of inertia of this plate about this axis of rotation. So, we can again write I big should be equals to I plus 3 times the moment of inertia of side plates, and this can be given as I plus 3 times the moment of inertia of side plates, we can write as I plus md square, which is L by root 3 whole square. So here this becomes I big is equals to, in this situation, it is I plus 3i plus, in this situation, this will be ml square. Now, in this situation, this value is 4i plus ml square. Now, in this situation, here we can write I big as 16i, we already calculated. So if we equate it to 16i, this implies the value of 12i is equals to ml square. The value of I will get here is 1 by 12 ml square. That is the result of this problem. Here I am leaving as an exercise for you to evaluate the same result by considering an element in the plate, and by integrating you can also calculate and verify this result.